just 14 years old, I was looked at dead in my eye by somebody that I trusted, somebody that I looked up to, as they called me worthless. Now, no, this was not one of those toxic, manipulative, mean 14-year-old girls that you get to know in the media or in movies. No, this person was way worse. So for a little bit of context about myself, I have played soccer since 4 years old, and I have played competitively since the opportunity came about. And as a freshman in high school, I was among four girls to make the varsity soccer team. Granted, we only had varsity and JV, but still the honor was there, and I was so excited to have this opportunity. Another thing that you should know about me is that I am super outgoing, super bubbly, gregarious. My mom calls it loud and bossy. But I like to think of it as social and really fun. But that is who I am as a person. And then one final thing that you should know about me is that I am a total people pleaser. I will do absolutely anything that I can to get others to like me. I care so greatly about other people. And all of this pertains to the story when I was 14 years old. See, it was just a typical soccer practice. My coach came up to us after the practice, to my friend and I, and he said, "Hey, we need the two of you to stay after for 30 to 40 minutes to practice with the JV team because they don't have enough girls for their drill." To which I replied, "Any other time, I absolutely would. My mom is in the parking lot. I'm 14. I don't have my driver's license. That's illegal. And she has meetings. She has work. Any other time, really any other time, I am more than happy." That's the people-pleasing in me coming out. And it was at this point in time, out of the blue, I don't know if he had just broken up with somebody or what the situation was, but this man, this 30-year-old soccer coach, looked at me, slammed his clipboard on the ground, the pen went flying as he screamed, "You're a worthless shit player, la-di-da-di-da," a lot of bad words, and I was stunned. Honestly, everybody who had ears that was around us, track team, baseball team, lacrosse team, they were all pretty stunned that these two 14-year-old girls were getting shouted at by their adult male coach. So naturally, I decided that day, I am never playing soccer again. I quit, I am out, people hate me, my life is over. I sobbed, but alas, I showed up to our soccer game the next day, and one of our senior soccer players actually approached our soccer coach and was like, "Dude, not cool. Maybe you shouldn't say those things." And so he came and approached my friend and I, and he was like, "Yeah, I was a little bit tough on you guys." And that was that. I had dropped it since. Flash forward 6 years, I'm in therapy. It's great. No, seriously, I'm so serious. You all should go. And I'm really serious. And in therapy, you know, I had talked about how passionately I cared about other people and how so badly I wanted other people to be kind to others. Because on that day, I had pledged to myself, man, I will never make anybody feel the same way that I had felt on that day. Truly defeated, crushed, stepped on, squished like a bug. And in our conversations in therapy, she asked, you know, where do these people-pleasing ideas come from? And I realized that this idea that I had kind of shoved down, this story, this experience that I had thrown into the back of my mind, was something that had affected me so greatly. It is the reason why in every single leadership position I have thrown myself into, the president of my sorority, student government, high school ambassador, you name it, I have ensured and kind of given myself a pledge that I will be kind to others. And a lot of you might be thinking, kindness and leadership, that sounds like a woman. Or it sounds like a pushover. And I can promise you, that is far from the truth. In fact, kindness should be rooted into leadership. But you might be asking, what is kindness? That's a good question. See, if you think about it, I want you to go ahead and just take a second and think back to your kindergarten classrooms, right? Or think to, if you didn't go to kindergarten, like a TV show or something where a kindergarten or a young childhood classroom is depicted. And I want you to think of everything that you see on the walls. You'll likely see colors, numbers, animals, the alphabet, the traditional, the huge. But you'll also likely see the rules, the posters, the motivational quotes. You might see the rules, "Be quiet. Don't pick your nose. Don't poke your friends." But you'll likely also see those quotes that say, "Be kind." Or one that I'm sure all of you have heard, "If you don't have anything nice to say, don't say anything at all." And it's funny because we force these ideas into young children, these young individuals in our society, and then we kind of lose track of them. Because I can guarantee that I am not the only one out here that has had somebody say something unkind to me since the age of 5. I'm sure many of us have had that experience. Clearly, my soccer coach did not listen to his kindergarten teacher when she said, if you don't have anything nice to say, don't say anything at all. And in this sense, I want to encourage you to think about how we can incorporate this into leadership. You see, traditionally, leadership had this sort of hierarchical stature, this sort of pyramid-like system. You can see it here where the leader is on top and all of the people below are simply inferior. See, traditional leadership not only has it as the man on top, we're changing that, but also has it where you are tough and you might say aggressive and you have no empathy, sympathy, or kindness for the people underneath you. And what I want to emphasize right now is that whoever is in that leadership position, CEO, president, governor, you name it, leadership is not created by the title in which somebody holds, but leadership is created by the people who create a culture worth following. Those of us who create a culture worth following is what creates leadership. Because let me tell you right now, I am not in a Fortune 500 company. I don't even know what that means. I'm not a CEO. I am not in the United States government. I don't even have my bachelor's degree yet. I have 3 more semesters until that happens. But I do know what I deserve, and I know what you all deserve, and that's human decency and kindness, no matter where that stands in leadership. My other question when it comes to this kind of hierarchical leadership standpoint is, what happens when you get to the top? You reach your goals and then you just kind of sit there for the rest of your life? Because that's boring. Do you reach your goals and then kind of tell everybody beneath you, catch up, come up here with me? Do you climb down and then climb a new mountain? Kind of looks like a mountain. What happens? Do you stop achieving your goals? So to kind of implement this idea of kindness and leadership, I've kind of thought through this idea of linear leadership. You see, linear leadership has the leader in front with all the employees behind them. So you can think of it like this. The CEO may be in the front. The few people behind them might be like the senior executives, and then a bunch of other people in the company, and then like the newbies, the college grads, people like me. And what's important to recognize is that while the leader's in front, something that we like to say, another cliche statement I'll throw at you right now, is that a team is only as strong as its weakest player. And I understand that these are all kind of cheesy, cliche statements that I'm throwing at you, but they're cheesy and we all know them for a reason. Every statement that you think of that you're like, this is silly, but we all know it, you know that statement for a reason. So in this sense, if your weakest player is on the far left side of that line, the leader should be able to step back, kind of help them move forward, because what we don't realize is that the leader's not sitting up there waiting for everyone else to follow them, but rather, the leader is the one making the way, paving the ground, paving the way for all of the people behind them to be successful. The leader is the one trudging through the mud, tearing down the corn stalks, whatever metaphor you want to use. The leader is the one doing that, reaching those milestones so that everyone else in your team can be successful. So in that sense, if the leader does jump back to the left to kind of help out these newbies and these rookies, whatever term you might want to use, what's important to realize with that is that this is a team. So the people just after the leader, these senior executives, they are more than capable, should be loyal and trustworthy, and able to lead the team from the front. Being the leader does not mean that you are hands down superior to everyone else or the best, because that's just false news. What it means is that you are willing to help those behind you. So what does that look like? You might be thinking, you're not a CEO, you're right. You're not in the student government, you're right. Actually, no, I am in the student government. But you know, all of those things. And what I want to emphasize is that a leader can be an older sibling to a younger sibling. If you create that culture where you're nice to them, it's rare, but if you are nice to your younger sibling, I love my little brother. If you are nice to your younger siblings, they want to follow you. Nobody wants to follow somebody who's mean to them. Parents can lead their children. You can lead your friends to good actions. You know, when they say, if they jump off the cliff, where are you? Don't follow that person. It's situations like that. If you think of all these cliche statements, they all go together. They're all congruent with this idea of leading with kindness. So what I want to emphasize to you is that no matter where you are in life, whether you've graduated from college, whether you haven't, whether you're at the top of your company or the bottom, at any point in this timeline, you can lead other people. Because leading is more than just giving somebody a bonus and saying, "You're welcome, I'm the best boss in the world." But it's also recognizing that the people who show up every single day and try their best are doing a lot for others. It's important to recognize that sending a simple text or recognizing that hard work is so important. That reaching out to other people and saying, "Hey, I'm checking in on you, how are you doing today?" is so important. And I can testify for that. Because while this soccer coach truly left a huge scar on my heart that has since healed, but it will never go away, those words, "worthless," still linger in my mind everywhere I go, whether I want them to or not. What I want you to emphasize or understand is that the person who I see as a leader was that senior soccer player who told my coach that what he did was not okay. Do you know how hard that is? I'm 20 years old now. She was 17, 18. I don't know how old all of you are, but to go to a full-grown man who had just screamed at two 14-year-olds and tell him that he was wrong, it's a little scary. So now, 6 years later, I have so much respect for this girl. She has no idea, might I add, how much respect and empathy and kindness I feel for her. I would do anything for her because of this insane action that she did for me that she probably thought wasn't a big deal at all, but to this day, it is what I remember. And I can tell you right now, I did not view that soccer coach as a leader, but I did view her as a leader. And this just shows you that if your leader is not truly being a leader, I'm using that word a lot, but it's effective, you can step up and take over that role. Leading with kindness might be something that you might think is cheesy, not effective. You might still think that it makes you a pushover. And I'm really sorry if you do think that, because I can guarantee you, if you choose to lead those around you with kindness and understanding, they will follow you. Because again, a leader is not created or determined by the title of your position, but rather leadership is just when people create that culture worth following. And I encourage you all to do that for yourselves. Thank you.